Hello, everyone, and welcome to this year's senior play.
We are so glad to have visitors again.
A few reminders before we start.
You cannot eat or drink in the auditorium.
If you do, Ms. Joyce will get terribly angry.
And trust me, you don't want to see that.
Please keep your phones on silent.
And there's no need to film or take pictures.
Because we've already got that covered.
And our cameras are top quality.
Also, if you see a loved one on stage, please don't yell or say things like,
"That's my baby!"
First of all, it's embarrassing.
Second of all, you might yell over the actor's line and that wouldn't be kind.
And the last thing we want to do is to thank you all for coming and abiding by the rules the government has put in place.
So, masks on.
Over your noses.
Because Miss Joyce does not like when your noses make an appearance.
But she is curious as to what the rest of your faces look like.
And I think that's all, folks.
Oh, one more thing.
Enjoy the show.
Yeah.
What are you?
I'm the wizard.
Wait, like, you do magic?
Like, the Wizard of Oz.
Oh, it kind of goes with my song.
Yeah, but it's a tornado.
What's a tornado?
Never mind. I've just got a lot on my mind.
Me too. I'm really worried about the environment and the climate crisis.
Just leave the kid alone, man. Can't you see he's worried about the show?
Oh, hey, if you ever get nervous, just imagine the entire audience naked.
Thanks, I think.
We'll let you be.
Well, break a leg.
I never got why people said that.
It's so you can end up in the cast.
Oh.
You look nervous, Jesse.
No, it's nothing, Leo.
Don't worry about the show. You'll do great.
It's not that.
What is it?
Other stuff.
I don't see what you could be worried about. You have everything going for you.
Oh, yeah?
I mean, you're with Liz. She's the nicest, kindest, and probably the most beautiful soul out there.
Yeah, she's great.
Great? She's better than great. She's amazing.
She's great. It's just... Never mind.
Come on. You will never do better than Liz.
You'd be surprised.
We have to get back to the auditorium.
Mr. Devereaux is going to yell so much if we aren't there by curtain call.
I love when Mr. D goes off.
Me too. Just not when I'm on the receiving end.
I feel so bad for the assistant to the assistant director. What's her name again?
Miss Bornak, Tony, you're always forgetting everyone's name.
Sorry, Tino, I'm not like you, or Sam. What's Miss Bornak doing here anyway?
I think she's a student teacher.
I think she's scared for her life.
Guys, look. Why is he torturing himself?
Maybe he's trying to see if Elizabeth and Jesse are on the rocks.
I think they are. Jesse never hangs out with us anymore, and he ignores Liz.
Exactly. I was in French class, and Madame Jonca said we can work in partners, and he completely avoided eye contact with me and Liz.
Who do you work with?
Diana the Dreadful.
It's weird. No?
So weird. I feel like he isn't even part of our group anymore.
We gotta save Leo from himself.
We know what to do.
I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head all be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain.
I'd unravel every riddle for every individual in trouble or in pain. With the thoughts that you'll be thinking, you could be another Lincoln if you only had a brain.
Oh, I could tell you why. The ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thunk before. And then I'd sit and think some more.
I would not just be a muffin, my head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. And perhaps I'll deserve you and be even worthy of you if I only had a brain.
Must we always be in character?
We must.
Must we must?
We must muster up the courage to always stay in character.
Look, the band is back together.
Feels like grade six all over again.
I was the best air drummer there ever was.
Come on, nothing compared to my air guitar.
You are all sadly mistaken. Nothing competes with an air tambourine.
Those were the days.
Were they?
I loved elementary.
I didn't choose the Harold Knapper life. The Harold Knapper life chose me.
It's been a hot minute since we all hung out.
So long.
I blame Jesse and his new interest in learning guitar.
Absolutely true. Whenever we hang out with Liz, you aren't there.
Yeah.
Are you getting any good?
Huh?
At the guitar?
Oh, yeah, it's easy.
And he doesn't even have any calluses.
Really? How often are you playing?
Like a few hours a day?
Well, I'm sure the calluses will come.
Hey, Wayne. Hey, Garth.
Hey, dudes and dudettes.
I still can't believe Mr. Devereaux made you two inanimate objects.
Have you forgotten? A twister. Anyway, listen. Without us, there wouldn't be no Wizard of Oz. We're integral parts of the plot. Without us, the Wicked Witch wouldn't lose her. Well, you know, and little Miss Dorothy wouldn't need new friends to teach her new life lessons. Ultimately, without us, Dorothy wouldn't realize that there is no place like home. So you're welcome.
You have a point, but still.
Your slippers. Ruby red slippers.
And you're a lion, Roar. At least I'm stylish.
And I'm a modest home for a family of four. Great resale value.
No judgment.
Wayne, I'm going to be frank.
Can I still be Wayne?
Sure. I'm super happy you're in the show, even if you don't have any lines and you stand in the background.
It's all good, my dude. I'm super happy for you that you have loads of lines.
Isn't that just beautiful?
B-E-A, beautiful.
Can someone point us in the direction of the auditorium?
We have to go to the electrician room next to the stage.
I hope nothing's wrong.
Just some maintenance.
Fairly routine stuff.
Good, because we have a show tomorrow.
We'll bring you back to the auditorium. I'm not a tremendous fan of Mr. D yelling anyways.
Only when it's someone else. Let's go.
I guess that means we should get a move on too.
Right on.
Guess that means me too. I'll see you guys later.
So, how do I look?
Green. Very green. And you're missing your hat.
I'm guessing that means I won't get a pre-dress rehearsal kiss.
I think that's gonna be a pass.
After curtain call, you'll be covered with green lips. You're still coming over after, right? My mom made your favorite pasta.
Yeah, I mean, maybe. I have a lot of homework, and we have all the shows coming up. And my mom's been on me about my assignments. And I have to practice guitar.
Okay, I don't know why she'd be worried about your assignments. I practically do them for you.
You need to get backstage, both of you. And it looks like you forgot your hat.
Oh, I should go get that. See you later. Oops, I should go get that. See you later.
Stop it. I feel bad enough as it is.
She'll get over it.
I was her first boyfriend. We've been friends since we were little. She liked me when I was the chubby, clumsy kid.
I like you now, and I always get what I want.
And you're the prettiest, coolest girl I've ever met. But...
there's no buts when it comes to me.
My friends are gonna hate me.
What friends? The the motley crew of awkward drama kids?
We are drama kids.
You need to understand there are two types of drama kids, them and us. Elizabeth is part of your past, are as the strange theater kids who break into song every chance they get. Do you want to go back to the part of your life where you weren't popular, you had no digital following, and everyone ignored your existence? I didn't think so. It's time you drop her like the dead weight she is.
She's not dead weight.
Don't I look pretty? You made your choice unless you've changed your mind.
I haven't. I just need time.
How about 30 minutes?
You know, Diana, I fail to see what the big deal is.
Get your eyes checked. I'm a star.
Sure. Mr. Devereaux wants us on stage for curtain call.
Who does she think she is?
Well, she has 1.2 million followers on Instagram, and she's been trending on TikTok for 3 days in a row. She didn't have to steal anything or slap a teacher.
I can't wait for the show to be over so you can break up with Elizabeth. We'll do it in a fabulous way, and we'll see who's trending then.
I feel so bad.
Don't. You know what they say. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. And if I remember correctly, you have a dance during the finale, so get rid of the guilt.
I know it can't be true. I'm not just going to lose my rhythm because I feel guilty. And I do feel guilty. See, the thing is, I have this uncle, and he's my role model, you know? He's younger than my dad, but still old, like 30-something. Anyway, I told him about my situation. You know how this incredibly popular and pretty girl Diana was flirting with me in French class, and how I was dating Elizabeth. He told me that the world was full of nice girls like Elizabeth. A dime a dozen is actually what he said. And my mom overheard the conversation, and she called him a misogynist and a chauvinist, whatever that means. He was disinvited from the Christmas party, and now I'm wondering if taking his advice was worth it. But look at her. Never in my wildest dreams did I think a girl like Diana would even look at me. But something deep inside is telling me that I made a big mistake, or that even worse, I could be perceived as an awful person. It's not true. I'm not gonna lose my rhythm. I can still dance. Why is this happening? It's not true. It's not. No. No. I can still dance. I can. I promise. I didn't do anything wrong. I'm not guilty.
Come on, let's go.
Remember your characters, ladies. Glinda, you're a ditz. And Elphaba, you're annoyed because you know you're perfect just the way you are.
Can I get someone to come check these mics?
I checked them.
The lights are flashing, which means the batteries are low. What's with her?
She is terrified of you.
I have the batteries.
Do I need to tell you what to do?
All good.
Great. Someone did their job.
Let's hurry up, people. This was supposed to be a fast rehearsal.
Sorry, we have to fish the Ethernet cable from stage to booth.
We're from the school board.
We didn't get any notification that you were going to be here. You know what it's like. We get a GRDS and have to complete it.
Will you be working in a catwalk?
Oh yes, exclusively.
Then it shouldn't be a problem.
Quiet on set! Ladies, dazzle us.
Elfie, now that we're friends, I've decided to make you my new project.
You really don't have to do that.
I know. That's what makes me so nice.
Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it, who isn't less fortunate than I, my tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper ploys when you talk to boys, little ways to flirt and flounce. Ooh, I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair, everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, 'cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Don't be offended by my frank analysis. Think of it as personality dialysis. Now that I've chosen to become a palimpsest or an advisor, there's nobody wiser, not when it comes to popular. I know about popular, and with an assist from me to be who you'll be, instead of jury who you were, well, are, there's nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. Lar. La, 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 la. We're gonna make you popular. When I see depressing creatures with unprepossessing features, I remind them on their own behalf to think of celebrated heads of state or specially great communicators. Did they have brains or knowledge? Don't make me laugh. They were popular. Please, it's all about popular. It's not about aptitude. It's the way you're viewed. So it's very shrewd to be very, very popular like me.
Why, look at you, Miss Elphaba. You're beautiful.
I have to go.
You're welcome. And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it, your newfound popularity. La, 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 you'll be popular, just not quite as popular as me.
Wait, Garth, come here.
Okay, Mr. Director.
You want to see some real speed?
Look, I really want you two to make an entrance at Curtain Call. I want the audience to laugh. When I mean laugh, I mean on the verge of peeing their pants. I want the house to fall over the slippers. Maybe that means you have to do some type of lift or go on his shoulders.
That's gonna be like quite the task, my dude.
But we're up for the challenge.
Great. I believe in you.
Did you hear that, Wayne?
Sure did, Garth.
The greatest Mr. D believes in us. You know what that means? We're not worthy. We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
I know this goes against my stance as a drama teacher, but it's a little too dramatic. Please get off the stage.
Sorry.
We're off to see you. The wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
It's good. Really good. Just make sure you're making a statement with your eyes. Since you're gonna have to wear your masks, it's all we've got. Can everyone get on stage, cast and crew?
Let's go.
Take a seat. Dress rehearsal is going relatively well.
And please remember to check the spelling of your name. If you don't, it could be misspelled or worse, not there. You can check with my student teacher, Miss Bornack.
Thank you, Miss Petrillo. I have corrected the initial spelling and some of you have changed it back. If you could stop doing that, please, that would be great. I'm trying my best.
I'm Diana with one N, not two.
You need to come check off the list.
I just told you.
Don't let her boss you around. You are a teacher.
She's a student teacher.
Watch it, Diana. Listen up, people. If you don't check the spelling of your name, you can't complain that you are Sarah with or without an H. I'm going to ask my stage manager to clear the wings and organize the props. It is a disaster back there, and we can hardly breathe, especially with the masks. Is there anything else, Miss Nyland?
Reminder about the masks. Please keep them on, and that means over your nose.
And those of you in acting roles, please try to maintain your distance on stage.
What about the people who have full face makeup who need touch-ups between scenes?
I know it is difficult to do so backstage, and I shouldn't have to repeat myself, but too bad. I don't feel like doing online learning anytime soon.
And I have no desire to see drama via Zoom. Worst year and a half of my life. On that note, let's take a 15-minute break for rehearsed current call. Go, go, get!
You know, Diana, seeing the two of you making out last week was totally uncool, and I was serious when I told you to come clean.
Are you seriously going to tell me what to do?
I have your hot tea in the wings.
I'm in the middle of a conversation, Janie.
It's Jamie.
Whatever.
It's the decent thing to do. That poor girl has no idea that her boyfriend has been messing around on her.
Did you know that my videos were trending on TikTok?
Listen, if we talk social media, I think I take the lead. And this is about being a decent human being.
And what exactly do you know about being a decent human being?
What have I ever done? That poor girl has no idea what's going on.
What are you, her keeper?
I'd want to know if I was in her shoes.
The nerve on that girl.
What?
She wants us to come clean to Elizabeth.
Right now?
She wants us to tell her we've been hooking up this close to the show. I feel like that's an awful idea.
Well, I don't know what to do.
Aren't you glad that I found you? Before me, you were short and dorky. Then you grew 8 inches, got abs, and I noticed you. It's best for you to move on from your past. I mean, what does Elizabeth have apart from being green all over?
I was her first boyfriend, and we've been friends since we were little. And I need to be kind when I break it to her.
Ugh!
I thought you wanted to wait till after the show.
Yeah, well, your hesitations infuriate me. And I need you to do this right now so that I can feel secure. I mean, look at me. I'm amazing and have over 4,000 followers on Instagram, and that should count for something.
Okay. Well, she's coming.
I'll leave you two alone.
I know I've said this before, but you look so cute as the wizard.
I try.
Getting comfortable with Instagram's second greatest?
Actually...
Is she as vapid as her TikToks?
Well...
Don't tell me you've been won over by the Queen of Mean. Last week, she made the student director cry. Did you guys become friends during French class or something? Should I be jealous?
The thing is...
Jesse, my love, she is a soulless, heartless creature who no one will think about after high school. Why are you so serious? What's wrong?
Look, we've been together so long. I just feel like I'm not growing with you. I mean, how can I evolve as a person when you're holding me back?
How am I holding you back?
I'm not the same person I was when we met.
We were 5 when we met.
Well, I'm not even the same person I was when we started dating.
I know! When we
we started dating, you were 5'2 with a coupe longueuil, and I never told you to cut it.
Well, I've changed.
Jesse, what are you saying?
Look, you're a nice girl. I just don't want to be with you anymore.
Why?
I do not love you. I need to explore my options. I need someone completely different.
Like who?
You're a nice girl. It's just, you're so ordinary.
Tell me who this extraordinary person is.
Oh, come on. Don't make this harder than it has to be.
I'm supposed to have sympathy for you. Tell me who it is right now.
It's Diana.
What's going on here? And who is filming this very tragic breakup? Diana, you cannot film real life tragedy. Your name is not Andy Cohen or Ryan Seacrest. And this is not every single relationship Chloe Kardashian has ever been in.
It was an accident. I went live for my fans and just happened to catch this.
Sir, it's my fault. I should have done this a long time ago. I just couldn't hide it anymore.
I can't believe this is happening. And I was the last to know.
It's over.
I know.
Whilst it is overly exciting to see high school drama unfold, I must say, this is not the time.
Or place. I feel like they should put their phones away.
Yes, absolutely. Put your phones away. This is utterly inappropriate.
I always thought Diana was a little devil. Well, now, I know.
She isn't a little devil. She's a quintessential mean girl. I'm just surprised that Elizabeth stayed so composed. I would have had a visceral fit.
Not everyone is as aggressive as you.
You're a disgusting human.
You just don't know what it's like to have a girl like Diana be into you.
Who are you?
What can I say? Nice girls always finish last.
You should be ashamed of yourself. You are utterly selfish and nasty.
Not you.
Absolutely. Gloria, go.
What?
You go.
Miss, I hardly know her.
She's my best friend. It should be me.
Gloria, pop two. You young man, are too close to this project.
I don't see how she is going to help.
The same could be said about you. Now stop your huffiness and sit.
Obviously, we're disappointed that you would put such an embarrassing moment on the internet.
It really was inconsiderate.
Oh, shut up, Sam.
Why does everyone care so much about this Liz girl?
She's not a venomous snake like you.
She's a nice girl.
And after the show, we'll be giving out appropriate consequences.
Controversial stance?
Yeah.
But
one must not punish the whole team. She'll get hers in due time.
Diana, your phone!
But Miss Petrillo, you don't understand. I can't breathe without my phone.
You'll learn. Hand it over.
This is unfair.
Imagine how Liz feels.
Now, Diana, come on.
Fine. I feel like I'm having separation anxiety.
It'll subside.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
I'm sorry. I don't speak to losers.
You made a big mistake, Jesse.
Hey, watch it, Tony.
Or what?
Enough! Get to opposite corners now!
Sorry, sir.
Sorry, sir.
No, he isn't. If he was sorry, it wouldn't have gone down this way.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Whatever, man. You'll have to live with yourself at the end of this.
Everyone, stop talking!
I have to make a call. Give me 2 minutes.
What do you want, Gloria?
I didn't break up with you. No need for the ice baby.
Well, what are you doing here?
Mr. D asked me to check on you.
Well, you can tell him that I'm an absolute mess.
Yeah, I can see that.
You're gonna report it to all your followers?
Look, I didn't have my phone out, and plus what I think they did was really awful.
I don't know what I did to deserve this.
I'm not sure you did anything to deserve this. These things happen, you know, and they're really terrible, but I think you'll feel better after some time has passed.
Said the most popular girl in school.
It's lonely at the top.
Then leave me alone at the bottom.
Fine! Have it your way. We're locked in.
What do you mean?
The door won't open. Do you have any bars in here? You can text someone to let us out.
I don't have any bars.
Help!
This is the old band room. It's soundproofed.
I knew that. And I keep forgetting the new band room with all the fancy equipment is in the E-wing now. What are we gonna do?
Live a very unhappy life together?
You would be so lucky.
I'm sure someone will come get us. Eventually.
What was that?
Do I look like an electrician? Help!
These must be the emergency lights.
You think the power went off?
Must have. Remember last year you lost electricity and the lights were kinda like this?
Yeah, and half the school left at lunch.
I didn't leave. Did you?
No.
Maybe we are more alike than we think we are.
I'm gonna go check the door again. It's open.
Okay, let's go.
What was that?
I'm not scared. You're scared.
It's okay, Sam. Right, Mr. D?
Yeah, it's probably just a breaker. Nothing to worry about. The school is cold.
No offense, Mr. D, but you don't look like someone who knows a lot about electricity.
I help the boys in the booth.
Doesn't Derek do all the work?
They've got you there, Mr. D. There's no need to panic. The emergency lights are on. We just need to make sure that everything else is turned off so that when the electricity does come back on, nothing explodes. And then we can call it a wrap for today.
What about Liz?
Someone should check on her.
Why are you so concerned about Liz? What, do you like her or something?
No, but I like her more than you, given your actions.
You should date her or something. You've always been good at taking what I didn't want anymore.
Good one, babe.
Someone should actually go check on the girls.
Clever idea. Miss Bornak, please go check on them.
Since we're finishing a little bit early, I'll be going over what's expected of you guys at the show tomorrow. I arrive at 5:30 in full costume and fully fed. So when the show starts, everything will be fully digested.
One year, a student ordered Benny Barbecue about 20 minutes before the show started, scarfed it down within 5, and then, well...
Well, what? I'm all ears.
Let's just say that the front row suffered from the movement piece and that the janitorial staff was not impressed.
L.
On another note, you'll also need to be in full makeup and decorated masks.
I can't believe we have to wear our masks.
Take it up to the government. It wasn't our decision.
And if your loved ones want tickets, they needed to have bought them yesterday, but we still have a few available online.
And they also have to follow all the other rules that are stipulated by the governments. And if they have complaints, I believe they can contact someone who has a higher pay grade than I do. I don't make the rules, I run the show.
My mom bought her ticket yesterday. She's never missed a show. She's seen Pearl Jam like 8 times.
Your mom's like really old.
Ancient, my dude.
Sorry to interrupt, but they aren't there.
What do you mean?
They aren't there.
I'll go check.
I checked both dressing rooms, the music room, and the hallway. They aren't there.
Laura! Elizabeth! They aren't there.
I had also checked the catwalk and the gyms, and they aren't there either.
They probably went on a walk or something. Everyone text them.
I don't have a phone.
I'm fairly certain that Elizabeth does not want to hear from you.
You could say that again.
It says message failure.
Of course you messaged her.
Shut it, Jesse. Message failure for me too.
Me three.
Everyone else is here, right?
Yes, they're all here.
Okay, let's not panic. Let's divide and conquer.
Phil and Jamie, upstairs and downstairs, C and B wings.
I hate going by the science labs.
Why?
Xantha once told me that there's a ghost in the downstairs B wing.
Toughen up, Buttercup. There are ghosts everywhere. Woo!
Tough ground.
Boys, D and E wing, and the second student lounge.
I hope we find them.
We've got this.
Poor Liz.
I know we will, because I have a very particular set of skills. Skills that I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
Oh, you're a nightmare, all right. You're lucky the teachers are here.
He's not worth it.
That's right. Keep walking.
Let's just hope they want to walk and they'll be back soon.
Hey, what about us?
You two? Just stay out of everybody else's way. I'm sure that you have done enough.